I'm excited to be here with Brian Judd, Museum Manager of the Hollywood Heritage Museum. And Brian, what have we got behind us?
Well, what we've got here, Pat, and thanks for joining us. We've got the oldest film studio in Hollywood.
And I'm excited to be here with Brian Judd, Museum Manager of the Hollywood Heritage Museum. And Brian, what have we got behind us?
Well, what we've got here, Pat, and thanks for joining us. We've got the oldest film studio in Hollywood.
This barn is ground zero of the Hollywood film industry. Is that an overstatement?
I wouldn't say so, no. I think that's true. That's certainly what we tell everyone when they walk through the door.
Cecil B. DeMille's office is in there, for one thing. So tell me the history of him with this barn.
Well, Cecil was getting into the film industry in New York. They had purchased the screen rights to a popular Broadway Western and decided to shoot it in what was, at the time, authentic-looking Western surroundings. So the place they chose was Hollywood. They heard that this building here was a rental facility that was available, so they rented it to begin production on what will become the first feature-length production shot in Hollywood. Rented the place for $250 a month.
Wow, and so, and was that Squaw Man? Is that the film?
That's the Squaw Man. It had been, it was a 1905 play that had done good business in repertory theaters and things like that, so they bought a property that they could afford that they knew audiences would like. So that was the gamble, and it paid off.
And we're right across from the Hollywood Bowl. You're here on Highland Avenue. What street was it on originally?
Originally, it was on the corner of Selma and Vine Streets. Yeah. That was the location from which they built the first Paramount lot.
And then it got moved to what we know as the Paramount.
That's right, the Paramount lot today. It was on their lot for 50-some years until we moved it to this location in 1983.
Wow. What's your favorite exhibit inside you're going to show us?
Cecil's office. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm excited to go inside. Let's get going. So, Brian, we're in your favorite exhibit, Cecil B. DeMille's office. Real quick, remind our viewers who Cecil B. DeMille is.
Cecil B. DeMille was one of the pioneering directors of the classical Hollywood world. He had been the son of a playwright, Henry DeMille. His brother William was also a writer who had worked on Broadway for David Belasco. And Cecil B. DeMille is responsible for shooting two versions. He does a silent one and a sound one, but he's responsible for shooting one of the few classical Hollywood films they still show on television.
Yeah. Still on network TV.
Still on network TV. Every Easter you can watch Charlton Heston part the Red Sea and the Ten Commandments.
Yeah. And so tell me a little bit about what we're looking here. We see a Ten Commandments book. I mean, are these actual artifacts that DeMille had, or is this kind of a reproduction?
We have a blend of artifacts in here. We have many of the artifacts are Cecil's actual artifacts that came from his estate, including, for instance, a typewriter right over there, which is the same typewriter his secretary, Stella Stray, used to type the script to the Squaw Man, that first feature.
Did he stay with Paramount? What was his trajectory?
Cecil was one of the founding partners of what will become Paramount.
Okay.
So he was their general director. His title, they called him the director general when they started production. And he had a couple of partners. They were later joined by a few more. And after a series of deals of different companies coming together, they created what will become Paramount.
So, Brian, this is incredible. This miniature, explain what this is.
Well, this miniature, Hollywood Heritage was very pleased to find this creation of a cabinet maker who had lived in Hollywood and had become so intrigued by the studios that he created this miniature and a few others, including a very large miniature that we have of Hollywood generally. But this particular one is designed to show the kinds of things that you find at any film studio.
This is the barn. Tell me what this used to be.
Well, now if you can imagine, at the time they're shooting the Squaw Man, both sides of this room in our museum were horse stalls. All horses on this side, and on this side, they converted five of the stalls to actors' dressing rooms. So You've got to put your pride, your theatrical pride, in a feed bag in those days, because you're going to share your dressing room with a quadruped. You know what film is.
Yeah.
I know what film is. We've seen it before. Yeah. But the children who come into our museum have never seen this sort of stuff before. This is 35 millimeter film. That's the dimension that was common in the classic, you know, year, well, all the way up into they started doing most things digital, whereas this is 70 millimeter film. And we have these two film sizes that help us illustrate our machines here.
I'm excited to be even close to this. Tell me what this is.
Well, the Technicolor company made very few of these cameras in the first place. This is a three-strip Technicolor camera. This kind of camera was required to get that lovely Technicolor effect, which is still almost unparalleled today. Now, it's essentially three cameras in one, because the light comes through the lens, it's split by a prism into the red, blue, and green spectrum in that tri-pack magazine in there, and DF11, that's the serial number, very special because it shot both Gone with the Wind and The Wizard of Oz.
That has been an incredible, incredible visit. Brian Judd, a museum manager here at the Hollywood Heritage Museum, thank you so much for doing this important work in preserving Hollywood.
Oh, it's been great to have you here, Pat. We're looking forward to seeing you all come on by and visit the Hollywood Heritage Museum, the oldest film studio in Hollywood.